Hear that? All right. I got my camera facing the phone, and when it makes it, I hear how loud that fucking thing is. Jeez. Uh-oh. A cult, are ya? Uh-oh.
Yeah, the kid in Washington might not know about the small dogs and cats.
What is?
The hawks. They're flying over the neighborhood here, and usually they're not over here.
Wow.
They're out in the open, you know, where they can see mice and that.
Yeah, we heard owls out here a couple nights ago, and Tracy said, you know, we got to keep an eye on a little bit, man. They'll see a little bit on the, down here, and they'll come flying down here and grab her and take off. Off in the distance, sometimes you can hear them, whoo, whoo, whoo. See, the river bottom is probably about a mile or just under a mile over the hills behind the trees. That's the river, and you hear them echoing almost sometimes. It's kind of cool. Sit and sing for a mate?
I don't know what they're doing. You know, that's all they do is sit there and sing when they're in a tree.
Mm.
But when they're flying around, they don't make a sound.
See, that's kind of cool out here now. You know, I notice all these different birds and whatnot. And like I said, the yellow finches, the canary, not canaries, the cardinals. Mockingbirds, bluebirds, we've had a couple blue jays. We've had probably about six different types of birds that are, you know, really not just one or two, but a bunch of them. They'll be coming back in the next couple of 3 weeks. If the chemtrails don't kill them.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got one rose bush out here for some reason. It's just... Tracy said it might be a vole in the ground that's kind of eat up its roots and stuff, because it looks like it wants to die, but then it's still got green on it, and it's got like one, now it's got two, four, maybe seven flowers on it. Four of them are opened up, and three of them are, one of them looks like it's about to open, and the other two are just buds on it, opening up. I mean, it looks all right, but the rest of them, but on the same side of the porch, there's another one. They're all put down at one time, all eight of them. The ones on the northeast side of the porch, the one all the way to the right, I mean to the left, it's got quite a few flowers on it, and it's a little tall. But then the one next to it is the one where, like you said, I think bulls got to the roots or something. And, it just doesn't seem healthy. But then as soon as you go to the next one over by the steps, it looks okay. And then on the other side of the steps, going south on the southeast side, they're all just bushed out with a lot of flowers on them. Really pretty. A Mother's Day classic. See, now the...
The extra pepper plant I bought?
Yeah.
I planted that one the same time as the...
Tomato?
The other one. And it's already caught up to its size.
Wow.
And it was about half the size of that one.
Bell pepper?
Those and the two tomato plants, they say 60 to 65 days.
Yeah.
I was reading up on them. But the beefsteak tomato is like a 90-day plant.
How long have you had those tomatoes?
I don't know how long they've been growing. What, 2 weeks ago? 2 weeks ago.
2 weeks ago is when you got them?
That's when I planted them.
Oh, but I'm saying they were growing though. I mean, they went from seed at that time.
Yeah.
They were planting. Yeah. So you probably got by about the end of June at the latest, you'll have tomatoes. I still say about the second week, first or second week of June, you might have a tomato out that one.
I can verify. Probably the end of July, when they'll start really blooming off.
Well, I mean, if you got a bloom, that means a tomato there, and you already had it for 2 weeks. Now just think of about another 3 weeks from now, whenever that is, and that would be about when you're gonna get the tomato.
I watered them 2 days ago. Don't rain like we're supposed to in the next 2 days until all the supposed to rain off and on.
Yeah.
Don't get any more rain,
then
I'm watering on Friday.
Yeah, that's good. Ooh, I was going off the porch and a big toad just jumped up into the bushes. I'm gonna walk over by the garden.
I don't want to overdo it on the watering either because.
Yeah, you'll get root rot. You'll get root rot in a heartbeat. That's what I did.
Well, I put the holes in the bottom for the water if it's too much of a drain, it'll run down.
Yeah, but you still have a lot of water in there and it's soaking in the roots. It'll be all around the roots all the time. And like I said, you get root rot. I would wait, you know, once they get growing, I would water them once every 10 to 14 days. That's good, but you'll have rain in between then, though. Out here by the garden, number two garden is the one off the porch. We got,
next time I water them, I'll put a teaspoon of
Epsom salt.
Yeah, and a half a teaspoon of Epsom salt in the bucket, because it's almost a gallon. We're going to be enough for the 5 plants.
Well, yeah. A gallon of water, you want 2 tablespoons of Epsom salt, and I would say 1 tablespoon of sugar for 1 gallon. For every gallon, 1 tablespoon of sugar, 2 tablespoons of Epsom salt. Epsom salt, again, I hate even saying Epsom salt, because every time I say it, I think of salt. It has no salt. It has some in there, but it's not. It's magnesium, and I forget the other ingredient. So.
No, that's fine. I mean, I know what you mean. But, 2 of those are 1 sugar for a gallon.
And just mix it really good and shake it up whenever, if it sits more than about, you know, 10, 15 minutes or so, just shake it and make sure it's mixing there good before you pour it out. See, our big, I had a watering can, red watering can, it's 2 gallons. I found out because I filled a gallon and I poured it in, it wasn't even about half full. And then I went ahead and measured accordingly and put it in there. And Tracy, like I said, and I put out the Epsom salt out of we got 2 gallon jugs, old milk jugs that we rinsed out, and poured a little bleach in there and rinsed it out real good, cleaned it out and rinsed it out again, and then we use that now with Epsom salt and water. So, but yeah, I planted some more, like I say, sunflowers out here because it looks so nice, and all of a sudden it's just all these bare areas. I'm like, why is there bare areas here? You know, I see a couple of sunflowers coming up, though, work from about 2 weeks ago when I planted, I guess. So after I planted yesterday, I planted a bunch of them, too. So maybe the east wall will build up in the next month or so. But, I mean, on the video here, I'm walking along the east end and it's showing you how small they look here.
No, you can't see them until you hang up the phone.
Oh, yeah. Well, same thing with this. This takes me a while because I have to transfer this video I'm doing with my video camera. The ones down here at this end here, I'm videotaping so you can hear it too. These here are the tallest. Those are about 18 to 20 inches tall right here. And you see, I'm showing on the video how. Now I'm going to walk through the garden here in the middle, the walkway, over to the west end, where these are taller and more dense. These here, these are minimum 18 inches to 20 inches all in here. There's a real thick, right when you come off the walkway in between the two gardens, there's a bunch of them right here. And these were the ones I was going to thin out. And I don't know if I should or not, but you know, then they start getting spread. But look at all this. It looks pretty cool. Now that I'm up front looking at them, I'm thinking, oh yeah.
I got to ask my son too, if I talk to him today, if they're going to have to call charcoal on sale.
Yeah.
They have to do like 20 pound bags of pink sugar for $10.
Are you serious? You better make sure you look at that good, because I saw 2 bags I forget what the price was. It was 15 something, and 13.5 pounds a bag. I thought, yeah, what a joke.
No, he's all right, though. Oh, no, if you're at China Market, see, like I was there yesterday, at that grill.
Yeah.
And then I saw the two 13.5 pound bags for 13 something.
Yeah.
And right next to it?
Yeah.
Right next to it is the 15 pound bag for $5.
God.
The ones that they sell over at Home Depot, they had the two. I think it's either 18 or 20 pound bags. I think it's 20.
Uh-huh.
That's what I have in the garage.
It'd be nice to have like four 20 pound bags or so. Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, I used to have two bags wrapped with plastic.
Yeah, and it's usually $10.
Oh, yeah. Let me walk back up here. I'm going to walk here and see the okra that's growing in here. Some of the holes, you can see them on the video camera here. Right there. I was excited this morning when I came out here and I looked and I saw the other shoot of corn coming up. I'm like, oh yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
We'll barbecue on the weekend. I don't barbecue during the week. You know, time.
Well, I did it because just trying it out. I cooked a couple of hamburgers on it, so they got real small too, of course, but you know. So what is it